format of a final accounts of a sole proprietor without adjustments. Here, in the books of name of the proprietor will be there. Here we are learning for a business house of an individual. The name of the person Ram, Hari, Gopal or Ram Sons or the business name will be there. And then the format, basic format, it is a ledger, debit, credit, trading and profit and loss account for the year ended, ending date will be there. This trading and P&L account is prepared, profit and loss account is prepared for the whole year, for the period, say 6 months, usually a year. In the debit side, we will be writing particulars with amount and rupee symbol. In the credit side, same particulars amount with rupee symbols. If I can tell you, and I have to start you from the credit side. In the credit side, all trading incomes or factory incomes and items which is the balance in the factory or in the business house is to be shown, including sales. First item is sales. By sales, write it down in the inside column, then deduct out of this less sales returns. Out of sales, sales returns is to be deducted, then less returns inward, one and same English. Somewhere it must be written in the question as a sales, the next sales return, and otherwise it is returns inward. Then less goods sent for sale or approval basis at sale price. Less goods sent on sale or approval basis at sale price will be there as a deduction. Next one is less sale of assets. Asset sale. Sale of assets. We are selling the assets and it is by mistake included in sales of the company or sale of goods. Then it will be deducted out of that to be shown in the final column as by sales. The next one is by closing stock at cost or market price, whichever is less. Suppose the cost of the closing stock, cost price of the closing stock is rupees 1 lakh and market price is rupees 80,000, then rupees 80,000 will be shown in the credit side. Then next one is by gross loss carried down. If the debit side will be higher, it will be totaled first, it will be taken to the credit side and there will be gap or difference in the credit side. This will be by gross loss carried down. This is balancing figure. And in the debit side, we will be writing the expenses and stock to opening stock, stock at the beginning of the year, to purchases. This opening stock is the closing stock of last year and current year's opening stock. Then to purchases, if there is some adjustment, write down in the inside column. To purchases, return will be deducted from purchases. Less returns outward, purchases return or return outward, one and same thing. Less purchase of assets, if we bought assets and it was by mistake included in purchases, then it is to be deducted. Less goods drawn or taken for private use, if the owner has taken some goods for his personal use at home, that will be deducted from purchases at cost price. Less goods distributed as a free sample or advertisement, if the business advertised, then it is to be deducted from purchases. And less goods destroyed by fire, if goods are destroyed by fire or any natural calamities, it will be deducted from purchases. Then less abnormal loss of goods, if goods abnormally damaged. And then in the final column, we will be writing the purchases, net purchases. Then to wages. Wages is a trading expenses. To wages and salaries, if the first word is wages and second word is salaries, that is wages and salaries, it will be shown in the trading account. This indicates more of wages, less of salaries. The total amount given, say 10,000, 9,000 rupees wages and 1,000 rupees salary, negligible amount of salary, it is a trading expenditure then. And salaries and wages will be shown in the profit and loss account. Then to octroi, warehousing charges, then dock duties, custom duties, if goods are brought through seaport or entering to the country through airport or seaport, then we have to pay customs duty. At times also, in the bordering, if we are in trade with the bordering countries and we are getting in roadways also, we have to pay customs duty. Then to clearing charges, then to carriage or freight. This clearing charges is when goods are cleared in the airport, seaport, or say on roadways between the countries, we have to pay clearing charges. Yeah, in airport also we have to pay clearing charges while taking out the goods. Then next one is carriage or a freight, or carriage or a freight inward, or to carriage or cartage inward, to all factory expenses in the debit side of a trading account, to motive or to power or motive power, to factory heating and lighting, to coal, gas and water, to sales tax or deducted from sales. Either you show the sales tax here or deducted from sales. Then total the credit side, then take it to the debit side, find out the gap, that is to gross profit carried down. This will be the balancing figure. Then go down to the profit and loss account and this write down this gross profit carried down was gross profit brought down. Then all incomes, official incomes in the credit side of profit and loss account, that is by interest on drawings. Interest on drawings is an income for the business because the owner is paying interest on drawings to the business because he has withdrawn the money from the business. He is paying interest to the business and it is an income for the business. Next one is by commission credit or commission received income. Next one is fees received income. It will be shown in the credit side of profit and loss account. This half is called profit and loss account. It is fees received. Next one is by discount credit or discount received. Then abnormal gain is a non-incidental profit for the firm. Rent received, income for the business. Dividend received, income for the business. Interest on investment, income for the business. Interest on loan given by the business to outsiders and interest received on that. Last year's provision for bad debt given in the trial balance credit side, that is also, if it is having a higher balance than the bad debts new provision, then it will be shown in the credit side. Then net loss carried down, balancing figure. We have to total the debit side. If the expenses are more, then we have to write down it in the credit side and deduct all incomes, whether business income or non-business income, or whether operating income or non-operating income. If there is a gap in the credit side, then that is by net loss write down. This is the balancing figure. Then all expenses in the debit side, office expenses of the business, that is like 2. If there is a gross loss, then it will be taken to the first hand, 2 gross loss brought down from the trading account. Then we will be showing all business expenses, official expenses, that is like to rent, rates and taxes, to salaries and wages, more of salary and a very negligible amount of wages. Only salary or first word will be salary and wages. If wages and salary is there, it will be shown in the trading account. To commission debit, commission paid or payable by the business to the outsiders. To discount debit, discount is an expenditure. To fees, repairs, it is also an expenditure. To loss by fire, it is an abnormal loss. To abnormal loss also. To insurance, to advertisement, to interest paid on loan taken by the firm. Because loan given, we get interest, it is credit, and loan taken and we are paying interest on that, that is a business expenses for us and it will be shown in the debit side of a profit and loss account. Next one being bad debts. to postage and telegram. Bad debt means the money lost while giving or selling goods on credit, you lost some money. Then to postage and telegram, to carriage outward or carriage on sales, cartage outward, to interest on overdraft or loan, to interest on capital, it is an expenditure because the business is paying interest on capital to the owner, to wages and salaries, to freight outward. Next one is freight outward. Then next one is traveling expenses of salesman, to depreciation, to ordinary or business expenses, to printing and stationery, to office expenses, trade expenses, miscellaneous expenses, then to any office expenses, any other office expenses. Then we have to total the credit side. If the credit side is higher, then we will take it to the debit side totaling and we will find the gap. If there is a gap in the debit side or difference in the debit side, it is to net profit carried down. This is the balancing figure. Then come down to the balance sheet. Balance sheet of our name of the firm or individual as at date will be given. Balance sheet is prepared on a particular date. Hence, after writing down the balance sheet of the name of the person or organization as at date, we will be preparing the format. Balance sheet is drawn on a particular date and the first line will be liabilities amount with rupee symbol, assets amount with rupee symbol. We can start from the asset side. The first one being current assets, or you can start with the fixed assets. If you start with the liquidity order, then current assets, that is under this head, cash in hand, cash at bank, bills receivable, sundry debtors, prepaid expenses, closing stock, short-term investments, short-term securities, marketable investments or marketable securities. These four are same, last four, that is this. These four are the one and same thing. Then short-term loans given by the business to outsiders. Then comes your fixed assets. The current assets head is gone. Then fixed assets, long-term investments, long-term securities, computers and laptops, furniture and fixtures, plant and machinery, land and building, motor vehicles, freehold premises, patents, goodwill, copyrights, trademarks. Then we have to total the asset side. Then we can go to this liability side and start with current liabilities. If you have taken current assets in the asset side, then we have to take current liabilities in the liability side as the starting balance. After that, under this head, we will be showing bills payable. Then next one is sundry creditors, outstanding expenses, short-term loans taken, income received in advance, bank overdraft, outstanding interest on loan, outstanding manager's commission, reserve or provision for bad debts, long-term liabilities and capital. Under this head, we will be showing bank loan, long-term loans. Then after that, we will have capital, add further capital introduced, add interest on capital, add net profit. If you have a loss, then less drawings, less interest on drawings, less net loss, then less goods taken for private use, less consumption, less goods taken for private use or consumption, private consumption or use. I have written both times less, but this should not be done. Then in the final column, we will be writing the total net value of capital. Then we have to add the liability side. If it is tallying with the asset side, then this is fine. And we have got the correct answer. And this is the final format.